Well, hello, U.S. history students. Mr. Olson here as we enter into our civil rights unit. I'm going to have a little PowerPoint introduction here in just a moment or two. Make sure you watch that. One thing I want to point out from our previous unit, the take-it-home exam. You had to submit those to Turnitin. I wanted you to basically look at the notes that you've been taking, the videos I asked you to watch, the little lecture I did, get a sense of the time period, the Cold War, and write in your own words things about the Cold War, or in, you know, towards the end of the unit, the Great Society and the war in court, Miranda versus Arizona. However, what I found, and you need to be aware of this, Turnitin.com works. A number of you, more than normal for essay homework, ended up plagiarizing. I'm just going to be honest. Turnitin exposed you. If you go to a history.com or Wikipedia and you just change a few words, you're still going to get busted. And I'm going to have to give zeros. I don't want to give zeros. Usually I'm a fairly liberal grader. Take the notes, put things in your own writing. I don't want to have to be calling parents, and I had to call a lot more than I've ever had before. You have plenty of time at home. I feel my lessons have been fair for the time to budget with your time during this crisis, this pandemic. But do your own work. That's just a tip for the next time. I'd rather see a little bit lower quality work. I'm going to give a lot of fours and fives on these essays if you do your own stuff. But if you plagiarize, I'm really stuck by giving you a zero because the evidence is there. All right, with that said, here comes our Unit 2 intro right now. Well, let's jump into our unit intro, and this is the way we will be doing it the rest of the school year. So I know you'll miss most of my, you know, lecture material, but the way I'm going to handle it is a short intro lecture each unit. Just a look ahead, no notes required. You'll see it says that right here. And then at the end of each unit, I'm going to have kind of a wrap-up lecture where I'll pick the key slides from your notes at home. And it's just a way to, you know, for those of you that, you know, might want help leading into our essay response at the end of each unit, it's a good way to get a sense of maybe some of the things I'll be expecting you to, you know, write about key things that happened during the course of a unit. So this next unit is, you know, kind of on the civil rights movement. It overlaps with our last unit on the Cold War that was occurring at the same time, but very different themes. The Cold War was about the race for power, and this movement, much of it in the South, but really in all parts of the country, was the movement towards civil rights. And the first big key thing that happened, and these are things we're going to talk about during the unit, is the Supreme Court case of Brown versus Board of Education, which basically overturned Plessy versus Ferguson. Remember, Plessy versus Ferguson back in 1896 stated that separate but equal was okay. Now, this was a blend. The Brown versus Board of Education was a blend of two or three cases involving schools and the segregation in schools that had all black and all white schools. You can see on the right side here that the Supreme Court ruled 9-0, saying that segregation was unconstitutional. It was separate but not equal. And this led to a whole change of events of things, particularly in the South. And then there was pushback against it. We'll talk about some of that pushback against it. Part of the pushback against it, the Little Rock Nine. This is kind of an interesting story, and you'll see a video on this, and you'll be required to answer some questions in the next couple of weeks. But in Little Rock, Arkansas, big, massive high school, Central High School, had about 4,000 kids, all white kids, and 9 African-Americans, higher-achieving African-Americans from the nearby all-black school, enrolled
in Central High School, so they would have better access to, you know, maybe higher end universities, etc. There were nine of them, just nine. This is the still shot. Many pictures were taken from the first day of school. And the nine knew they would face racism from the all-white student body. So the agreement was that they would all meet together and go into school together. Well, this one gal here, I think her name is Elizabeth Eckford, got separated from the pack, so she had to walk in alone. And you can see this gal right here behind her. These are all high school students. This is mom escorting her daughter to school. This is another high school student here. But you can get the sense, the look of hatred they have for this gal. Interesting thing is this woman here later on became friends with Elizabeth Eckford about 10 or 15 years later. She was embarrassed about the way she had behaved as a high schooler. But this was the mindset in the South. And these nine kids, and you'll see a video about them, dealt with all kinds of racism at that high school over the next, you know, several weeks and months. All right, this is obviously famous. You probably have heard of this. The famous Rosa Parks personal bus boycott. You know, she got on the bus, and of course the expectation in the South was that as an African American, you sit in the back of the bus. Well, she was involved already a little bit in the civil rights movement. She refused to yield her seat at the front of the bus, and she got arrested. Eventually, it led to a citywide bus boycott. And we'll see about this during the unit, but this is also something else that kind of spurred on the civil rights movement. I'll be expecting that you'll watch a video. You'll do it at home. I'll send you the links. This will happen next week. And it's a great video called Eyes on the Prize. It's a couple hours of time, so next week you'll be just doing this video, and I'll have one little notes thing posted. So I'm going to, you know, try and keep it so the time is fair for what you're doing at home. But you'll be watching this video called Eyes on the Prize. I'll probably break it up, and next week you'll watch part one, 1 hour, and then the following week, the third week, you'll finish the final hour as we kind of wrap up the unit. All right? We'll, of course, talk about Martin Luther King and his movement of non-violent resistance. He was a genius in the things he did with regards to getting publicity, you know, getting things in the media. I know we hear a lot today about the fake news and all that, but in those days, Martin Luther King utilized the media to get footage on, you know, TV networks, and people saw what was happening in the South. He intentionally wanted to fill up jails, get people arrested. We'll talk about the Freedom Riders, whites and blacks together that rode buses from the North into the South in an attempt to, again, get rid of the ideas of segregation to integrate these buses. We'll see a video on this during the unit. We'll meet Malcolm X, a little bit different from Martin Luther King. He didn't really agree with nonviolent protest. And you can see the quote here that, you know, kind of lends to that. And both Martin Luther King and Malcolm X, by the way, were assassinated during the civil rights movement. They were both taken out. So we'll meet both of them and their different viewpoints. And then towards the end of the unit, we'll talk about the rise on the West Coast in particular of the Black Panther movement, which came out of Oakland. So these are all some of the things that we're going to look at during the next couple of weeks or so. And it'll work the way it's worked the first few weeks of this remote learning. You'll see the notes from me to take it home on your own. You'll see some questions that go with videos, book homeworks, etc. Get those to me any way you can.
Okay, so for this first week, you'll see there's one day of notes. There'll be an assignment or two. So due on Friday. In general, I'm trying to make assignments each week. Do Friday, shorter work this week because we had our assessment that came out yesterday. But still, this assignment due by midnight on Friday. There'll be another posting next Monday, due the following Friday. I'm hopeful that this is allowing you, the student, to kind of space out the workload from my class so you don't have things due real quickly, and you can budget your time to watch the PowerPoint notes, take the notes at home, watch the videos, be answering the questions, doing the book work, etc. And of course, getting that to me in many different fashions. You can post through submissions on SchoolLoop. You can email me pictures, PDFs, Google Docs. I'm getting lots of different ways that students submit to me, but I'm trying to be flexible with that. Continue to do the work at home. Stay safe. Maintain that social distancing. And we'll see you again via video next Monday. Stay safe out there, U.S. history students.